Welcome to my Texas workshop. I'm Randy Lammers.
I'm Aaron Keevan.
This is Worth Knowing. How would you like to assemble faster, with fewer workers, less fatigue, repeatable tension, and instant verification? Today, let's talk about twist-off tension control assemblies. Chris Tribble, welcome back to the Texas Workshop.
Happy to be here again.
All right, man. Hey, so you gotta tell us a little bit about this. These are twist-off, also what commonly known as, we call them TC bolts in the construction world. Those are all gonna be under RCSC, right? Their famous RCSC book.
You bet.
Is that true?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So this is one of the approved installation methods. It's going to be used anywhere that you would use an A325 or an A490 connection. The different designations for the tension controls, or the TCs, or everyone's favorite vernacular, is going to be an F1852, is that 120 KSI group, or the F2280, which is that 150 KSI group.
All covered in ASTM 3125.
Yes, sir. That's all in F3125. And then the installation methods and the testing are all listed in the RCSC manual.
Okay, excellent.
Back to it. So you do have to have some special tooling for this, is that correct?
Yes, sir. So This is the one method that you gotta have a special tool, and this is what's known as an electric shear wrench.
Cool.
So what makes this kind of special, if you notice on the bolt, it's got a spline end that's beyond, and this internal socket on the shear wrench is gonna hold onto the bolt. Well, there's a lot of benefit to that because now it makes it a one-man, one-side operation. So you don't have to have anybody hold the back of the assembly. Everything's done from the front end.
That's the fewer workers part.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Check.
Check.
The interior socket is gonna hold the bolt steady and it's gonna rotate the external socket to rotate the nut until we get to the appropriate torque system, because this is really a torque-based system.
Right.
You know, our common torque formula, the T equals PKD.
Well, we say T equals KDP, but same thing, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. So what the manufacturers have done with these assemblies is they've done all that math for you. That we know our torque because it's gonna be consistent from the gun. It's an electric gun. It's always gonna give the same torque.
Okay.
Your friction factor, the K, which is usually the one you're always solving for in your pre-installation verification, they've taken that out as well because these all come specifically from the manufacturer in an assembly form. It's always gonna include the bolt, the nut, and the washer, and also the required lubrication. So these have to be used in as received condition.
Okay, I'm going to reiterate that then. So the bolt manufacturer has taken control of the frictional factor with very specific finish and K, what we call K factors.
Absolutely. Don't mess with it.
Don't mess with it. Okay.
So, as received condition is what you'll hear a lot of phrases. You guys have heard me talk about storage. Everyone out there has heard me talk about storage. Storage is the most important when we're talking about these tension assemblies.
Yes.
It has to be how it came in as received condition. You have to have the protected storage. Got to take them right out of the keg. You got to take them into the steel and do what you need
to do. From warehouse to job site, always maintaining that storage.
Absolutely. Yep. Again, it's gonna be faster for installation, it's gonna be less training, it's one tool, you don't have to calibrate the tools, but you do have to follow the rules. So all the work's been done for you on the front end,
but you've gotta
follow the rules, absolutely.
Okay,
goes back to it. So a couple of things that are critical here. Snug tight, that is a critical feature of these, yes?
It is, because when we get to snug, once we apply the wrench, it's gonna do what this wrench is designed to do with this assembly. If you've gotta catch up that air gap, the wrench doesn't know you have an air gap, the TC doesn't know you have an air gap. While these are a wonderful product, they are not a magic bolt.
Okay.
There's no electronics inside of it, there's no sensor.
No gauges, nothing there.
There's nothing on the inside that goes, oh, now I'm detention, let's pop off. This is a mechanical interaction of something that's been specifically designed for one purpose.
So once that reaches the torque it's designed to reach, then that end will twist off?
Yes, sir. So the most important factor here is right where that spline ends, you'll see the groove. And that's where really most of the design work has been done by those manufacturers. We have our lubrication, we have our diameter, we know our force. We have to make sure that that's designed for that specific point.
All right.
So that the tools and as well as the bolts can do what they're designed to do.
Exactly. Excellent. And these are always going to be manufacturer certified. So they should be lock controlled, just like we always talk about. That's going to be the case for these also.
100%. And within the structural bolting world, within most of the fastener world, this is kind of unique in the sense there are no secondary processes we can do to this. We can't add lubrication, we can't add a coating, we can't change the configuration or move lots. This is from the manufacturer how it is. If you have material that's been degraded or exposed to the environment,
right,
it has to be recertified by the manufacturer. There's not a bolt house, there's not an inspector, there's no one on site that can do that. It has to be done by the manufacturer because ultimately, they're the ones that certified it in the first place.
Okay, if those don't twist off, can I come back with a hammer and just knock them off?
Absolutely not. First of all, it'd take a heck of a swing.
Okay.
But let's assume you weren't hammering and you had a grinding wheel laying around.
Yeah.
Then you're just not doing what it's designed to do.
Right.
It may look that way, but ultimately what we're talking about is safety.
Exactly.
So our connections have to be how our connections are designed. All so right. Any corners you could cut, all you're doing is ultimately making a degradation of your product.
All right, very good. You've brought the Skidmore load cell again. Let's demonstrate this.
Let's do it.
Twist off some bolts.
Well, all right, we're all set up here at our demo. Obviously, well, I was gonna make sure we've got our safety glasses on. Chris is gonna be operating our tooling and getting this demo done for us today, so he's got the gloves on. Now, some of the things that we didn't talk about when we were discussing with Randy, the types of finishes that are permitted on the TC type bolts or twist off bolts.
Again, because these are coming straight from the manufacturer, right now the specification only allows on the 120 group that F1852s or A325 TC can come plain finish or in mechanically galvanized. Again, because lubrication is so important,
yep,
we don't want to introduce any heat to this. For the F2280s, the A490 TCs, sure, the 150 group, the only current coating that's allowed is the plain finish. We can't add galvanized and we can't, even the zinc flake coatings that are allowed in the hex bolts, we can't do these to the tension bolts. And again, because it's coming from the manufacturer, there's nothing anyone else can do either.
Exactly right. And then another thing we didn't talk about was instant verification, right? What are we gonna see here?
Yes, sir. So right now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the pre-installation verification. Because again, this is a torque-based relationship. So the gun and the bolt are designed that when we get to the right torque, we've created our tension. We need to verify that in the load cell so that we know that this assembly, this lot, bolt nut washer, when we get up into the steel, it's gonna be where it's supposed to be. So it's not snapping again because it knows that it's at tension or whatever. When it gets to the prescribed torque, the design torque, that spline end is gonna shear off and we're gonna see that we're in the range, at least the minimum required tension. This is a 3/4 inch bolt, so we're at least over the 29,000.
Let's run the test, Chris.
So we're gonna get to snug tight. You see we've already done that. We've got a register on our gauge here. And then we're gonna take our shear wrench. Again, we've got our inner socket that's gonna grab onto the spline end of the bolt and our outer socket that's gonna rotate the nut. We're gonna get full engagement, pull the trigger until the spline snaps off, and get to check our tension to see where we get.
See that instant verification.
Got that aligned and tight in there, and go.
Awesome.
So you saw what popped off. You see our spline end here has now separated from our bolt.
Sure.
It's attached in here. We've got a quick release here on the gun. That's gonna remove our spline end. We've exceeded minimum tension, so now we know when we get to our steel, this lot is going to reach at least the required minimum tension before our spline end shears off.
Exactly right. So the other thing that we've talked about is this being a time saving. So we'll have Randy come in and we'll set up another test on our seal plate.
Absolutely, let's do it.
All right, cool.
You've seen the PIV. We know this lot is approved. Installation time equals man hours. Man hours equals cost, so we can save a lot of cost with the speed of this installation. Let's demonstrate that.
Yes, sir. So we're gonna run through here. We're gonna run through these. Again, we've got one lightweight tool. I'm one worker on one side.
Okay.
We don't have to have anybody hold the back. We're just gonna kind of run through here.
All right. Take it off, dispose.
Cool.
In terms of what it takes to install six bolts, typically two people, that is really, really quick. So to give you further information and demonstration, what we've done is we have set up a scenario where Chris can explain some issues that we see commonly out in the field.
Yes, sir. So we're gonna talk about kind of common failure types. So this first one, we put it in our steel, we got it ready to go. Then we went back and we plumbed up our building, and it's been a couple of days since we put it in there.
Yeah.
Well, you can see that this bolt is a little bit, it's been exposed to the weather, the rain, the heat, the humidity. All of that's gonna affect our factory condition lubrication.
Right, so not getting the same frictional factors.
We're not gonna, and so we've altered that formula, so now we're back to our design isn't gonna work anymore.
Okay.
Next real common thing we're gonna see, it's on there, but that's not snug tight.
No.
Snug is right, not tight is right, snug is right. We've got to get to snug to make sure that, because again, like we've talked about all the times before, a bolt is not bringing your steel together, your bolt is holding your steel that's already together. It's acting like a
clamp.
Yep. Absolutely.
Okay.
And then lastly, we've got one, it got dropped, it got dirty, it sat out, it was on top of the can.
I keep telling Randy. You know, you gotta take care of these things. They need to be in the can, and he doesn't do it.
I really let these sit out on the porch for a while. Go ahead.
But it looks fine.
It looks really good. I thought I cleaned it up.
Okay. Well, what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna try this cleaned up bolt, as you want, and we're gonna see if there's a difference in the factor versus the ones that we just did.
All right. Like, looks nice.
It doesn't look very snug either, and it looks like we're spinning on all kinds of sides. So, looks like we got a good connection, right?
It snapped off?
It snapped off, so everything's good.
All right.
So, we don't always have this option, but since we're standing here in the Texas workshop, we can see just how good that connection was.
Okay. Exactly. All right, yeah, because those were just hand, okay?
Yep.
So we pull these off.
Oh, that did not give you, what was that, 39,000 pounds of load that was supposed to be?
Again, because we've altered the frictional factor because we messed with the lubrication.
Right.
We left them out in the rain. We let them get exposed. It's still going to react to the torque that it needs to get to.
Right.
But that torque equation has changed.
Yes.
Because we've altered other components. And now we've got a bolt that's not meeting its minimum required tension.
Thank you for that, Chris. In conclusion, twist-off TC bolts are an approved method of assembly in the RCSE specification.
Yep. Following those same guidelines that are in there, we have to obviously worry about the lubrication that's put on it and how they're stored.
Correct. Because these are coming from the manufacturer certified as an assembly, you can't change out your components, you can't mess with your lubrication. Manufacturer's done all the math for you, so you have to use them in as-received condition to make sure that they perform how they're designed.
And you also need to ensure you're using the right tools for the right bolts.
Definitely. Special tools, special bolts, but it's again, that goes back to the time savings and the one-side installation.
And that snug fit during that contact when you actually start to put those together.
The TC bolt is designed so that when you get that snug tight fit, it can start to perform how it's been designed to. So snug is absolutely critical before you begin your installation.
TC bolt assemblies will save time and effort, but you must follow the guidelines. Time saving and instant verification with twist-off tension control bolts. Using Chris Tribble's favorite word, that's absolutely worth knowing.
Thank you, Chris, for coming on the show. We'll see y'all next time.